How are you feeling? You got John Riggs here. I just want to do a quick update on where I'm going to be between now and the end of the year. You know, after too many games rolled around, I had a few people reaching out to me saying, hey, I'm going to be at too many games. Where can I find you? I was like, I'm not going to too many games this year, unfortunately. Maybe next year. But there are some gaming conventions I'm going to between now and the end of the year, and even a little bit just after the end of the year too. So where you can find me. And just a couple of other quick little project updates. I've been working on my serial book, working on my NES game, and I want to tell you all about those in this video as well. Before I get into that, I do want to let you know that this video is sponsored courtesy of our friends at Otis. If you're not familiar, Otis is an alternative investment app that allows you to buy and sell shares of tangible collectibles. There's weekly drops, including a mix of what's happening today in pop culture, not just retro gaming, which is my favorite thing, but there's also sneakers. There is collectible cards. There's art, so much more too. A couple things you might want to watch out for are the WADA graded 9.6 Super Mario 64. That's coming out right quick. Keep an eye on Metroid for NES. You know, Metroid Dread just came out for the Switch, so NES Metroid, something to consider. WADA graded 9.4 on this one. And right now you can check out the Super Mario Brothers for the NES, WADA graded at a 9.4. Now there's no promise on ROI, but instead of like paying full price for something like one of these like WADA graded items, you know how many thousands of dollars they go for. You see it in the news all the time. You can at least say that you own a piece of that. And when it comes to buyouts, there are two ways to do this, either by selling your shares on the secondary market or if Otis accepts a buyout offer on the underlying asset. Sign up for Otis right now using my link in the description below. In fact, they'll even get you your first share free with your funded account. Thank you. So, conventions I'm going to. You can find me next for the very first time at Retropalooza in Arlington. This is in that Dallas-Fort Worth area. I think I said that right. Hold on. In the Dallas-Fort Worth area. That sounds right. It'll be my first time in the Dallas area ever. Now, earlier in the year, I attended Retropalooza Houston. I had a wonderful time. The staff were so accommodating and friendly to me. My pleasure to return to get that red carpet treatment. Not just for me, but for the guests as well. Always a great time, and this is the big one from what I understand. I had such a great time at Retropalooza Houston when I attended it a few months ago that if that's any indication whatsoever, this one in Arlington, Retropalooza, it's coming up the third weekend of October, and you have to be at this thing because this thing is going to be insane. Ton of other guests are going to be there. I'm going to be there, and I'm going to have a table too. So if you're looking for your very own copy of my homebrew, Beavis 2. I am going to sell these online soon, and we'll talk about that here later on in this video. But grab one for me, save the shipping cost, the CIB, right in your hands. And I do have a few issues left of my serial book. Now, the hardback version is coming out later with the added chapters and everything, but this is the first print run. This is the, if I ever make the New York Times bestseller, this may be worth some money, probably not. It'll probably be worth about the same, but it's literally just a book on different breakfast cereals. And I'll do a full video on this later on, again, when the hardback comes out, you know, when we kickstart that thing too. But just to get the sneak preview, I'm gonna have those with me as well. Get your tickets in advance. You're gonna save cash when you get your tickets right now. You gotta be there. This is Retropalooza. Don't miss out. I saw all the people having so much fun at other conventions earlier in the year too. That fear of missing out, man, FOMO, it's a real, real thing. And thanks to your votes, I'm going to be at Midwest Gaming Classic the first weekend of November. Now, I'm not showing up as a guest, however, I am going to be there to hang out all weekend long. I'm not doing any panels. I don't have a table to sell stuff. That was the contest where I had a sponsor pay for my flight, for my hotel, for my VIP passes. So I'm going there as a fan. I'm not getting any special treatment. I'm not getting in the front of the line. I'm not showing up, you know, 2 hours before everyone else digging through the merchandise. I'm just showing up. I'm going to have fun all weekend long. I've never been to Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I'm looking forward to, I hear beer and cheese and brats and Blue Moon ice cream is what's on my agenda when I'm there for Midwest Gaming Classic. It's going to be fantastic. Midwest Gaming Classic. It's going to be fantastic. Ooh, I got to write that down. That might be a good rhyme for a rapper or something like that. Now, it's not to say I won't be on a panel at Midwest Gaming Classic. I'm not slated to be on one at this very moment, but if someone else has one and wants me to sit with them on their panel, that may happen. But in the meantime, if you see a guy who looks like me but taller wearing a mask, it's all good, man. Just come on up. Say what's up, you know, grab a selfie or something like that. I'm totally cool with that. Absolutely, anytime. It'll be my first time ever at SAC Gamers Expo. Looking forward to it already. December 18th and 19th. I know it's the weekend before Christmas. Christmas break, winter break, should be a fun time. Maybe you're home for the holidays. Maybe it gives you a chance, you know, school, pending and all that too. Fly out to Sacramento, California, or drive up if you're in the LA area. Should be a good time. I'll be there. Pixel Game Squad will be there. NES Complex, all great buddies of mine. Jay from Game Chasers, Shady Jay is going to be there too, and a lot more guests. Make sure you check out the website. Make sure you grab your tickets in advance. Cost efficient way to have some fun, and I will be there. It's my first time ever. So let's see if we can make it a big turnout here for Sac Gamers Expo. Sacramento, California. I'm looking forward to it already. And then after the first of the year, the end of February, bringing back SoCal Gaming Expo in Ontario, California. Ontario, California is right next to Los Angeles. But Ontario has their own airport. It's a beautiful thing. I've flown into it before. Great airport. Nice and easy and stress-free. And I am planning on attending that one as well. So if you're looking forward into 2022, so already into next year for 2022, you're looking into SoCal Gaming Expo at the end of February. Gotta check that out. That's gonna be awesome. And again, if you're looking for the homebrew for the NES, it will be available online for sale as well. If you can't hit up expos, I totally get it. I'll be able to have this available for sale online too. Still working out all the details. When that happens, I'll make an announcement on social media. I'll make an announcement. I'll probably do like a live stream, maybe some giveaways, both on Twitch as well as YouTube. And this game also coming as a eShop game, as a digital, for the Nintendo Switch. So if you don't want the NES version, you're just like, I just want to play the game, you'll be able to download it for the Switch. And that's coming out very soon too. We'll get you more details when that's actually finalized. That should be a lot of fun though. I'm super excited about that. And again, same with the serial book too. Very, very soon. I mean, this is just the prototype. I just had to print off a few, had some copies printed off just so I could make sure that, you know, like the colors looked okay and everything. There was a couple of spelling errors I had to check out. But when the full version comes out with the new chapters, like, you know, with the better cover and everything like that. I mean, this is almost like a magazine right now, but we're gonna do it big on this serial book because that's something I'm super passionate about. And again, that'll be another video. It'll be another live stream. It'll be another announcement when that's available for purchase as well. But in the meantime, I do have a few of these left that I'll bring to Retropalooza as well. And there are other expos that are happening between now and the end of the year. There's one like the last weekend of October in Chicago that I wish I could attend, but that would be like three expos in a row, three weekends in a row. That's a lot. Whether I'm there or not, show your support. If you can, if you can make it, if you're good to go, let's show some support and hit up these expos as much as we can, and let's get it going, man. Now, the same weekend as when I'm in Milwaukee, Wisconsin for Midwest Gaming Classic, across the way in Connecticut, there is Retro World Expo. Now, I can't be at two conventions at once. It's all part of the voting poll. The voting poll went to Midwest Gaming Classic, so I'm going there for the very first time. But still, if you're on the East Coast and maybe can't make it to Milwaukee, check it out, man. Retro World Expo. It's going to be a fun time. Metal Jesus will be there. I wish I was there hanging out with him too, but again, like I said, maybe next time. You never know. I haven't seen Portland Retro Gaming Expo in a couple of years. I missed that one. Game On as well. One of my personal favorites, Mo Game Con. Hey, I had a great time at Southeast Game Exchange. Maybe I'll have to return to Southeast Game Exchange. Greenville, South Carolina. What a great time I had there too. I love to travel. I love video game conventions. I love meeting people, and maybe I'll see you around too. But let me know in the comments which conventions I should check out. I should go out of my way. It's just like, you know, like maybe there's a convention that I've never gone to, and you're like, dude, you need to go to this one. Where is it, man? Let me know in the comments.